Well, with weather warming up, restaurants are transitioning from comfort food to some lighter springtime dishes and all of the wonderful vegetables and seasonal things that they can throw into them. We have executive chef Marque Collins here, and he is from Tullibee. And Tullibee is, of course, in the Hewing Hotel, which is a hot spot, such a beautiful spot.
Thank you.
So you walk in, there's the bar, and then Tullibee is in the corner over here,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, Tullibee's on the side there on 3rd and Washington.
And then you have the rooftop as well.
We do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, people love it. Do you still have the sauna on the roof as well?
We sure do.
Okay, great. So here's a beautiful shot of what this looks like. If you've never had a chance to get there, my goodness, it is a great spot to stop. Make a reservation. Of course, you can hang out in the bar until your reservation, because that's a great spot to be,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, exactly.
And I love all of the spring vegetables that you brought. Let's talk about them, because maybe people are like, what is going on over here? Like, what are these things? So first of all, what's this?
So these are ramps. So ramps are a breed of wild onion. They're native all over kind of the Midwest. They cannot be grown. They're only foraged in forests. So they're kind of the first spring vegetable to pop up as the weather turns.
Yeah. Okay, that tastes great.
Yeah.
And then these are so beautiful, but tell us what these are.
So these are fiddlehead ferns. So these are little baby ferns. They're, again, kind of a spring vegetable because these are the ferns before they uncoil as they keep growing.
Gosh, they're just stunning.
Yeah, so they're kind of very young and tender and bright. Delicious that
way. Then, of course, a lot of people do know that this is a very special item over here.
Yeah, people that know. So these are morel mushrooms. So these are, again, only foraged.
A lot of foraging going on. I love this.
Yep.
And then some fresh.
Yep, yep. Tullibee, we always love a lot of dill.
Okay, wonderful. So how do we make the salmon dish?
Sure. So we have here, this is our salmon. It's a Norwegian farm-raised salmon that we're really happy with. It's sustainable. It's great throughout the year. What we do is just very simply roast the vegetables here. So we have the fiddleheads, some morels, and then we throw the ramps in there at the end. We're just gonna finish
it. And some good old butter. Gotta put the butter in.
Well, you know, as healthy as you wanna be, we do like to finish a lot with butter, so.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, exactly.
As Marjorie Johnson would say, absolutely no margarine, everyone, only butter. So anything she says is golden, is the Bible, so I believe it.
I think people think that butter is bad for you, but in moderation, it's, you know, it's not processed.
It's perfect.
It is pretty healthy.
You have so much salt flakes there.
Yep. Season it with a little salt. We've already kind of roasted the morels and the fiddleheads here, so you kind of see
they have a beautiful color. Oh, that smells so good. Okay, so how did you make that crust? I'm always wondering how to do that. Did you take skin off the bottom, and then how did you make that crust on the top of the salmon?
That is the skin, so we left it
on. Okay, that is. Okay, yep. That's what I was going to ask you. Okay, so
yes.
That's what you prefer to do that, keep all those juices in there?
Yeah. Yeah, I like the texture of the skin. It adds a little bit of fat, too, to kind of protect the filet as you're cooking.
It's super healthy for everyone, right?
Oh, yeah.
Super
yeah,
healthy.
Very good. So
all right.
Once you have everything kind of roasted up here, we don't get too crazy with our plating. We kind of go with our morels and our fiddleheads.
That's so pretty. So if you weren't going to order this, because this looks like this is one of your favorite things that's on the spring menu, what would you order at Tullibee?
One of our more popular spring dishes is our ricotta gnocchi. So it's made with the local sheep's milk that we make into ricotta, and then we turn that into a gnocchi, and we do it with a pea, mint, and ginger sauce.
That sounds great.
Yeah.
So now, obviously, you're a hotel, so you have a lot of folks coming in from all over the place. But then you have all the locals coming by as well. And the North Loop has just been so popular. And as of late, I think a lot of people love going down there.
Yeah.
There's so many options.
Well, I mean, it's really turned into a great restaurant scene as well. You know, it used to be kind of Hewing there over 7 years ago. But now there's a lot of great restaurants around. So it's really nice to have that kind of community.
Yeah, because more
there.
Is better.
Oh, yeah.
More is better when it comes
to
restaurants.
More people coming and having fun is always better for us.
You've got Gavin around the corner.
Yep.
You've got Daniel Del Prado around the corner.
Yep.
You have the
David
French
Fima
place.
Down the corner.
David Fima around the corner. Yeah. And what's the last thing you're going to do here?
So last thing we have here, this is some smoked trout roe. It adds a little bit of salt to it. And then we make a white wine butter sauce called a beurre blanc.
Nothing wrong with that.
And so that's how we finish our dish.
Oh, how pretty is that? That is absolutely gorgeous. Look at that. Well, thank you so much for bringing it, and thank you for sharing it with
thank
us.
You.
We are going to taste it in just a minute. Calm down, okay. Tullibee, thank you for coming on, sir. Tullibee is located in the Hewing Hotel in the North Loop, and we have a link to this recipe. He gave it to us. How great is that? On KARE11.com. Text the word recipes to get all of our recipes that we do on this show and throughout KARE11 throughout the week, 763-797-7215. And coming up,